You see, Bhagavad Gita is the very essence of yoga and Vedanta. And it gives you two powerful ideas for mind control. You know, this was Arjuna's doubt to Krishna. Same our doubt. Same thing going on. He also said, Chanchalam hi mana Krishna, pramathi balavad dridam. Tasyaham nigraham mane vayo rivasudushkaram. I find the mind very difficult to control. It's like the air. Balavad dridam, so strong, powerful, self-willed. I have nothing to do with it. Please check your thoughts and see, are you thinking or are thoughts happening? Thoughts are happening or are you thinking? You're thinking? Be frank. Both. Sometimes you think, especially when problems are coming, then otherwise it's happening. It's by default, it's going on. What is going on without your permission? Even actually, physiologically, every organ is doing its own work. You are not doing anything. Please see. Your heart taking your permission to pump blood? Lungs doing anything with your permission? Things are automatically going on. Like that mind also automatically going on. And we are just watching. Are kya ho raha hai? When it becomes too much, then we take some conscious step. Otherwise, it is going on. But there is a way of bringing this mind under control, bringing it into our hands. This system, not so easy to bring, the physical system, but mind you can. Because, why should you? Because happiness is a state of mind. If the mind is not in your hands, you cannot be happy at will. Some external force is required to keep you happy. You know, mobile, internet, addiction for all this can keep you a little entertained. Comfort and security they give, not happiness, but we call that happiness. But all this you require to keep you a little stable and balanced and happy, so-called happiness. External things are required. But if you have this knowledge, you keep yourself happy without any of this. Nothing of this is required to actually keep you happy. Because happiness is a state of mind. Mind conditioned rightly, full of positivity, yields happiness just like that. All these are disturbances to such a mind, you know. This is possible through yoga. And the way to that is this, what Bhagavad Gita is telling you. This is the answer Krishna gives to Arjun's question. How do I control the mind? He says, Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. You can control it through practice and through vairagya. Don't get frightened of vairagya. Vairagya doesn't mean becoming sadhu. It means keeping out of your mind what you don't want to experience. There are many things which you don't want to experience, which are impinging on your mind. Keeping that out is vairagya. Leading such a noble life, such a great idealistic life, that the negativities will not come into your life. And abhyas, you know, repetition. Anything you repeat becomes your nature, becomes your sanskar. You know, neuroplasticity, huge concept in neuroscience today. Brain is neuroplastic, which means what you repeat constantly, it will change its structure accordingly. What you repeat in your mind gets etched on your brain and it changes the structure of your brain. You can change yourself at any point of time. You are not hardwired for suffering, for stress, for fear, for negativity, never. Your life and your mind is in your hands. Simple methods you must be able to draw from your own culture in order to keep this balanced state of mind. See, simple points. Abhyas is the workout of conditioning mind along positive lines, right? And vairagya is meant to rewire the inner circuitry of emotions through righteous indignation, which means what? Something which is not of any worth should not find place in your life. Itna sa vairagya hona chahiye. Hai na? Obviously, if you want to lead a good life, I must distance myself from the bad. Wo vairagya hona chahiye. So this much we can easily do.